When I first started, I did my first bee relocation by myself. It was an utter failure. But out of that failure, I learned to be better. I'm John Chong. I'm the founder of Bee Amaze Garden and my very own brand of honey called My Honey. And right now, we are all at Bee Amaze Garden. Bee Amaze Garden basically is a motivational, educational, edutainment center whereby I educate students, schools, families, and organizations using bees as example. As a beekeeper, I have to go around Singapore and then to look for these colonies of bees, put them into my beehive, and then bring them to Bee Amaze Garden. So that's how I started my bee rescue journey. There's a misconception that bees always, when they see you, they will come and sting you and cause harm. Bees are not like that. Not like what Hollywood movies portray them to be. Wow, killer bees, huh? The sight of you means they're going to sting you, no? No. If the bee land on hand, just admire. Wow, out of so many people, you are the chosen one, the bees land on you. Isn't that a wonderful thing? You need to enjoy all this little moment whereby this connection with the nature, connection with the bees. What I look forward most is to see my visitors coming in here. Some of them have fear. Oh, they think that bees will harm them. And purposely, without any protection, I put my face next to the flower, next to the bees. This to demonstrate them the point, hey, when the bees are out foraging, they're not out to harm us. They end up having a very close encounter with the bees. I make sure they all must have protective gears. At the end of my lesson, they say that I'm no longer afraid of bees. That's the most satisfying. Every bee is a very precious to me. It's a precious life. So I cherish life. They are the ones that can produce honey. I hope to be the first Singaporean to produce Singapore honey. When I transit from vice principal to become a beekeeper, my friends just call me crazy. I was really obsessed with the bees. I could teach good values, or whatever good values we can find in the bees. They are on their own. They want to be productive. Bees are responsible for 1/3 of all our food sources. Imagine 1/3 of all food sources, all this gone. We really need to look after the bees and cherish them. As a teacher, we want to be engaging. So I combine all these multi-intelligences and use of 5 senses when visitors come in. It's similar to what I used to teach when I was a teacher. Basically, get them all engaged. There are so many good values we can learn from the bees. They're all conditioned to look after one another. So I hope our students just look at the bees' behavior and they will incorporate all these values into their own life. When I first started, I reached out to 10 beekeepers in Australia. The advice they gave me was just do it. And they learn along the way and join beekeeping club and learn from others. I learned from my mistakes. As I corrected the mistakes, I become better. I learned to love the bees, to show respect for the bees, and also to treat them with utmost care. If we can relate with the bees, then we can understand how to work with the bees. You gotta pursue your passion. It has to be so consuming, so compelling. Don't just follow the mainstream. When the passion consuming, then you must really go for it. That's why you should welcome failures. When I was in school, we always talk about successes, right? Failure is part and parcel of learning. We use failure to fail forward, to spur us to do better. For example, I did my first bee relocation by myself. It was an utter failure. But out of that failure, I learned to be better. For aspiring beekeepers, read books on beekeeping. One such book is A Practical Guide to Farm Skills. From this book, I learned how to look after the bees. It's just one book. There are many other books to read from. So So read as much as possible, and then learn from other beekeepers, just like me. For those who want to follow their passion and make good in their life, love what you do and believe in your cause. If I were to summarize my life journey as a book, the book title would be Meant to Be, because for 37 years as an educator, I was teaching others. I learned how to be a beekeeper, and also now I'm also an educator. Therefore, I call myself, I'm meant to be a beekeeper educator.